Morning, Steve Frey in Chicago with the Morning Grain Comment. So overnight, we've got beans higher, corn unchanged, and wheat a little bit lower. Each of the markets are trading a little bit different fundamentals, and it's hard to kind of gauge how long these markets are going to trade these specific fundamentals and what impact it might have. Over in the beans, the Chinese are coming in to Washington later in August to try to talk about some resolution in the U.S. and China trade issues. There is a feeling amongst people that there could be a resolution when they come in. Why else would they be coming in? The perception is that maybe their economy has slowed down or maybe even stopped, and that maybe this is critical for them to kind of come up with some type of resolution. They have been trying to do everything they can to replace U.S. soybeans with South American soybeans, with different types of proteins, with different types of feed rations, and now they have an outbreak, a small outbreak, of swine flu in the hog herd. And so all these things probably suggest that they're not coming in because they need U.S. soybeans, it's because they need to get their economy back going. So now November beans is back over $9, and I'm guessing that if they do come up with a resolution, there's at least a 50-cent rally in beans. And with the 780 carryout, farmers should take advantage of that rally and sell some cash soybeans, or at least buy some puts. As far as the corn market is concerned, it's unchanged. We've got the Pro Farmer Crop Tour this week. So the corn price will probably follow those state yields versus what the USDA came out in August. Some farmers feel that, in general, the corn yield is not as good as what the USDA said in August, and that deserves some kind of bump in higher corn prices. We also note that when you look at 19, these corn, the ratio of soybeans, 2.35, that favors corn. So the U.S. farmer is probably going to increase corn and lower bean acres in 2019. So the U.S. farmer should be thinking about selling some of that corn cash-wise while these corn is over $4. We could see another maybe 20, 40 cent rally, so if you want to wait for that, that might be okay. But take advantage of these prices when you have, especially in the high yielding areas, your corn next year might be making a profit relative to cost. And wheat down, I think on Friday, the Commitments to Traders report said that combined Chicago KC wheat futures, as far as funds position is concerned, is record high. And I think the market, even though prices really haven't made new highs, the fact that the funds are record long is probably going to offer some resistance to the marketplace. Still, it's not raining a lot in Europe. It's not raining a lot in the eastern part of the former Soviet Union, and it's not raining in Australia, and it's not raining in Western Canada. So all those things still suggest that the crop is probably smaller than what the USDA said in August, but we really need to see increase in U.S. export demand for wheat in order to push wheat prices higher. As far as U.S. is concerned, we've got a rain system going across Iowa and Illinois today. This will help the bean crops there as far as if you get more than, let's say, an inch of rain. The 6 to 10 day and the 8 to 14 day are all calling for below normal precip and warmer than above temperature. So this rain is critical for those areas that get it. As always, these are my thoughts and not those of ADM or ADM Investor Services, and have a safe and profitable trading day.